Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. Get us? Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. We don't know what we should pray for. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. You hear that? I say it all the time. The Spirit is going to the Most High with groanings that cannot be uttered. We can't even get as sad as the Spirit is going to the Most High on our behalf as to go to Him to bring forth the intercession between us and the Most High. And He that searches the hearts knoweth what it is the mind of the Spirit, because He maketh intercession for the saints, who are the 12 tribes of Israel, according to the will of the Most High. You know? So He got to go to the Most High with groanings that we can't even groan, it's so sad. And He got to go there, He got to figure out whatever we're saying and make it work with the Spirit of the Most High, which is the Word of the Most High. We got to make sure that He's going there in the most humblest position that you can think of and can't think of, but we can't even, what is that? Groanings which cannot be uttered. We can't even utter the groanings that the Spirit is going to the Most High with, as humble as can be. And here we are, mortal men and women, thinking that, you know, trying to estimate and calculate the Most High. I don't think so. Know what? He's beyond our comprehension. That's more than men. That's more than women. First Chronicles 28. First Chronicles 28th chapter. And look at verse 8. Now therefore, in the sight of all Israel, the congregation of the Most High, and in the audience of our power, keep and seek for all the commandments of the Most High, your power, that ye may possess this good land, and leave it for an inheritance for your children after you forever. You're supposed to keep the commandments of the Most High. But what do we do? So we can keep the land forever. With Daniel 9:11. Yeah. All Israel have transgressed thy law. Over and over. Say, we're going to do what's right. We're going to follow your law, Most High. Especially after He jacked us. We always say, oh yeah, we're going to do what's right. We're going to do what's right. Yeah, all Israel have transgressed thy law, even by departing, that they might not obey thy voice. Therefore the curse is poured upon us, and the oath that is written in the law of Moses, the servant of the Most High, because we have sinned against Him. See? We sin against the Most High, therefore those curses that's written in the law of Moses, Deuteronomy 28th chapter, the 15th verse on down to the 68th verse. And all other places where it coincides to the precepts of what He would do to us if we didn't follow His rules and regulations. And He have confirmed His words, which He spake against us, and against our judges that judged us, by bringing upon us a great evil. See, people don't understand. Do you realize, just talking about the Most High, brought a great evil upon us? For under the whole heaven, have not been done as has been done upon Jerusalem, upon us. As it is written in the law of Moses, all this evil is come upon us. Yet may we not our prayer before the Most High, our power, that we might turn from our iniquities and understand thy truth, understand your law, Most High. Until this day, therefore hath the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel, watched upon the evil, looked upon the evil, all the evil that the so-called white man done to us in slavery, even until now, every verdict is not guilty for killing us. Therefore hath the Most High watched upon the evil and brought it upon us. He the one that killed and make alive. For the Most High, our power, is righteous in all his works which he doeth. For we obeyed not his voice. See? We don't obey him. So we're going through what we're going through. Imagination of our hearts and our thoughts. We got to seek him. He knows our minds. He knows what we have in mind to do and the things that we do in our actions, proving whether we love him or not. You see? Look at Romans 8. Romans 8. Romans 8 and 32. Romans 8 and 32. He that spared not his own son, that's the Most High. He spared not a Mashiach Yahushua, but delivered him up for us all, for the 12 tribes of Israel. How shall he not with him, a Mashiach Yahushua, also freely give us all things? He's going to give us all things, freely give us all things. Who shall lay anything to the charge of the Most High's elect? It is the Most High that justifies. He can't lay nothing to the charge of Most High's elect. So who is he that condemned it? It is Mashiach that died. Yeah, rather, that is risen again on the third day. Who is even at the right hand of the Most High, who also maketh intercession for us, you see? With groanings that cannot be uttered by us, he maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Mashiach? Make an intercession for us. So I say, no man comes to the Father but by me. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. The Father can be glorified in the Son. Who shall separate us from the love of Mashiach? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, danger, or sword? Modern day sword is a gun. For it is as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. And you see that. We really sheep for the slaughter now. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Yeah? We more than conquerors, if you want to be that. Or you could be weak. Say, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, no matter what level they are, nor powers, nor things present in this life right now, nor things to come or in the future, nor height, no matter how high you go, nor depth, how low you go, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of Mashiach Yahushua and the Most High, which is in I have shown myself the other side out, and I say, come back to judge and make war, and set righteousness up on this earth forever and ever and ever and ever. Mashiach got shot. So we gotta give glory to glory belongs. That's to the Most High. So you thought enough of us, the sin of Mashiach Yahushua here, to die and to rise again for the children of Israel's sins, that we can be forgiven. And the mercies of the Most High, which are plentiful, overwhelming, we can have in these last days. Because he's the only one that we're going to, be saved. The only way is through his blood. All honor to him. So with that, I'm going to open up the lines for questions.